Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. We have some big bits of news for this video today, starting with yet another launch of 60 Starlink satellites on the Starlink 27 mission, which lifted off earlier today. Following liftoff, the Falcon 9 booster B1051 landed successfully for the 10th time on the drone ship. Just read the instructions.
Stage 2 FTS is saved.
And there you have it. We have a confirmation of a successful 10th landing of this booster and the 83rd overall successful recovery of the Falcon 9 first stage.
Kyle Montgomery posted a picture on Twitter of the Crew-1 Dragon capsule Resilience when it returned to Port Canaveral. There's a new article from Space News which says the US Space Force this month will complete a design review of a previously flown SpaceX Falcon 9 booster that launched a military GPS satellite to orbit last fall. The booster is expected to fly another GPS satellite sometime in June. Over in Boca Chica, the orbital launch site tank farm work continues. The pieces for the integration tower at the propellant production site are continuing. The cryo tank shells at the propellant production site are progressing too. In the production yard, the orbital launch table is continuing. Musk was asked about the Starship timeline on Twitter, saying, "Still aiming for 2026 launch window?" Musk responded and said, "2024 is not out of the question for an uncrewed flight." A booster common dome section was recently flipped into the correct orientation. By now, there's almost zero chance you've not seen the SN15 flight, but on Wednesday, Starship SN15 successfully lifted off.
Plus 30 seconds, Starship 15 is airborne as we get a view of the three Raptor engines as we're powering our way to 10 kilometers altitude in today's test flight.
SN15 then performed an absolutely beautiful landing to place itself smoothly down onto the landing pad.
Ignition. Starship heading back to the landing zone. And Starbase Flight Control has confirmed, as you can see on the live video, we are down. The Starship has landed. We're going through the safing sequence.
Starship has made history and SpaceX have proved that the concept is completely viable. Elon Musk posted a tweet after the SN15 flight and subsequent landing saying, "Starship landing nominal." There was an exciting tweet also posted by Elon Musk in relation to SN15. Teslarati posted an article saying SpaceX is working through the night to secure the first Starship to survive a high altitude launch and landing. Musk responded and said, "Might try to refly SN15 soon." Michael Baylor posted a tweet saying, "Iterative development, it's the SpaceX way." Musk responded with, "Only way to create rapidly and fully reusable orbital rockets, the fundamental technology revolution needed to make life multiplanetary." Here's a beautiful shot of the SN15 prototype standing tall on the landing pad. Tankzilla was moved back to the launch site to help with SN15 recovery operations. After being placed on the self-propelled modular transporters, SN15 was moved to the centre of the landing pad. The legs were then also removed from beneath. This is the Starship serial number 20 mid-liquid oxygen tank section. A piece for the upper part of the super heavy booster number 3 tank can be seen here sitting outside. There's also this super heavy BM3 aft section outside still. I forgot to include it in my Wednesday video, but to finish up this video we have the latest Starship and Super Heavy build diagram thanks to Brendan Lewis. It goes without saying, but we wouldn't have these detailed Starship updates without Mary, known as Boca Chica Girl, out there all day every day filming, so thanks to her. Also, I would like to say thanks to Jack Beyer, who often edits the NSF videos and has been out there for the SN15 launch also filming, so thanks to him too. Then also thank you to the hard-working NASA spaceflight team behind the scenes bringing us fantastic videos, live streams and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.